living in Germany as a Chinese teenager and already feeling like I'm not the regular beauty standard, I came into cosplay as definitely a wallflower. But I can dress up as a character that is stronger than me, that is more confident than me, that is more beautiful than I see myself. And through the act of dressing that way, you gain all of those attributes. I'm Yaya Han, and I'm a costumer and cosplayer. I have my own copyrighted cosplay accessories line. I have a t-shirt line. I have my own line of wigs with purple plum. I'm a pattern designer from McCall Patterns. I'm the first cosplayer to have her own fabric line, exclusively available at Joanne Fabrics. I have my own comic book with the publisher Line Forge, and I've been on 2 reality TV shows. And I travel to about 25 conventions a year worldwide to cosplay.
It's been pretty amazing to think that I got to do all of these different photos, not only, you know, in various settings, but all over the world. Like, this picture was shot in the Philippines. So it's Philippines and Romania and just all over.
Cosplay is the art of dressing up as a character that you love. The scene when I entered it in 1999 was so tiny and so underground that we were shunned at conventions by other attendees. Like, cosplayers were absolutely the freakiest of the geeks. It has developed into this absolute vibrant global phenomenon. It is being practiced all over the world. People from all different cultures and on every continent cosplay. That is something I never would have dreamed of. Well, my mom grew up in China, you know, like, and went through the Cultural Revolution and such, so she absolutely did not think that doing any sort of creative job would amount to success or money. I mean, really, she was just very concerned about my well-being and if something as esoteric as cosplay could ever turn into a actual career. And honestly, for many years, I wasn't sure if I could do this either. She was worried about me throwing away all of my chances, and there were a few years where she really did not support me and we didn't really speak very much, partially because of the choice that I made to open up a costume commission business and do it full time. Well, this is where I live and work and make costumes and all that good stuff. And usually the first thing that everybody wants to see when they walk into this door is the collectibles room. This is the result of a lot of compulsive online shopping and a lot of research. And yeah, Brian and I, we set up this room to house all of our collectibles. It's really weird, but once you cosplay a character, you like, it's almost like you bond with them for life. It's so corny to say, but I end up seriously just literally like falling in love with my character, and I start collecting everything that they're on. So yeah, like, I collect a lot of figures of characters I've cosplayed, like Jessica Rabbit. Emotionally, it just means so much to me to collect figures and other merchandise of characters. Oh, I have something cool that I could show you guys. Okay, so this is the first garment I ever sewed 17 years ago. And I am absolutely shocked that I still have it, first of all, because I've moved several times. And part of me is actually kind of impressed with how I put this piping in, but it is rough. This is sad. This is Yaya's first sewing job. We're dressing up as fictional characters that sometimes were designed to be superhuman beautiful or have all of these great physical features and, you know, all of these assets that you know, regular people just don't have. And so when a cosplayer strives to achieve that superhuman physique, if she's successful, then she's being judged for it. And if she's not successful in people's minds, then she will also be criticized for it. I'm a dinosaur. I'm a dinosaur of cosplay. I've been doing this for half of my life, and it has given me so much, but it also wears you out. If you're like me and you came to this country as a first generation or a second generation immigrant, you have to work harder. You have to know that people will not always understand what you've been through, and you'll meet people that take their lives completely for granted. In a way, I'm really glad I came to America by myself and that I had no support from my family, because it taught me how to work hard and to persevere, even in very, very dire moments. The pool is only gonna get bigger. Cosplay is only gonna get bigger. So I will keep playing the long game, because time will tell. And eventually, all these people kicking and screaming and being upset at me, they'll still use my fabrics and my patterns. And I will be happy for them, because they get to make a costume using good materials.